Everyone, thank you for tuning in today. Happy Saturday. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome. My name is T and this is my channel, Crumpacy and Sewing. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you a fabric haul as well as some patterns that I just picked up from the recent Simplicity sale that Joanne was having last week. So stay tuned and I'll show you everything that I was able to purchase for my fabric haul and also my pattern haul. So first and foremost, I want to welcome all the new subscribers. I see I have quite a bit of subscribers, and so I want to go ahead and welcome you to the Crumpets Tea and Sewing YouTube channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. And for all of my existing subscribers, those of you who support me week after week, thank you so much for tuning in today. So today I'm going to go ahead and get right into the video, and I'm going to share with you all of the fabrics that I purchased, and I'm also going to share with you a few patterns as well. So the patterns that I purchased are more on the athletic side, so I want to start doing a lot of activity wear for just for my own personal preferences, because I want something to wear while I am working out, and I have not yet made anything within the last, I would say, 4 or 5 years. And so I want to go ahead and make some activity wear for me. So I am going to be working on that, hopefully towards maybe towards October, maybe September, October. So I went ahead and purchased a few patterns, and I'm going to share with you those patterns in a little bit. But first, let's get into the fabric haul. So the first piece that I'm going to share with you is nothing new. This is something that you have already seen, and I already made a garment, actually two garments out of it. And I loved it so much that I decided to repurchase this from Fabric Mart when they restocked it. So when I saw that they restocked this beautiful black and white print, I decided to go ahead and repurchase it. And so this is a black and white cotton lycra. It's a floral poplin shirting fabric, and it's from a famous dress designer. So, you know, Fabric Mart has these different categories of designers, and this falls in the famous designer, famous dress designer category. And so I wanted to get one more yard of this fabric here. And this is the fabric. And yes, I know many of you are probably tired of seeing this, but I absolutely love this fabric. So I decided to get one more yard of it. And I want to make a top to go with the skirt that I made. And I'll go ahead and pop a picture up here. I'm gonna scoot over here. And I'm gonna go ahead and pop a picture here so you can see what the dress looks like and what the skirt looks like if you didn't have an opportunity to see it, or even if you did have an opportunity to see it and you want to refresh your memory of it. I'm going to go ahead and show you what that looks like, and as you can imagine, I think that this would be really cute and in a top, maybe a notched collar top. So I was thinking about the McCall's pattern M8198, which is a recent pattern. It has different views. It has like a crop view. It also has a view with a tie belt that you can actually cinch in the waist, and it has like maybe a little peplum, like it kind of creates this peplum at the bottom of the top after you cinch in the waist with the drawstring. So I was thinking about something like that, so I could have a matching set to go with the skirt. So that's why I went ahead and purchased another yard of this. So there is another piece that I purchased from Fabric Mart as well, and it's this beautiful crimson white black 100% floral print crinkle challis. And this one was $5.25 a yard, and it was on sale, so that's why it was $5.25 a yard. I think it's originally like $14.99. So I purchased 2 yards of this. Now, this was a fabric that I actually chose for a blog post, and so I received 2 yards for free. But after I seen the 2 yards on the monitor and how rich and vibrant it was. And then when it came in the mail, I thought it was just so gorgeous. I decided to order 2 more yards of it. And so it just came in the mail. And so I'll show you an image here of what that looks like. And as you can see, it's very flowy, it's drapey, it has a fluid drape. I really love the drape of this, and I think it will lend itself well as some type of a maxi dress or a really cool, nice, flowy summer dress or something like that. And so that's why I decided to go ahead and get 2 more yards of that. There's one more fabric that I decided to repurchase, but this was not from Fabric Mart. This was from fabric.com, and it's of this mustard floral fabric. Now, I had this fabric 2 years ago, and I made a McCall's tiered dress with it, and I'll show you the image here, and it turned out lovely. However, the bodice part of the dress no longer fits me, and so I lost a lot of weight in my shoulder, especially in the shoulder area since then. And so there's a lot of bunching and unnatural gathering up at the top of the shoulder. And so it doesn't really look right because it doesn't lay flat on me anymore. And so I decided that I was going to go ahead and seam rip the skirt from the bodice and recreate something totally different. So I'm going to add a waistband for the skirt part of it and then make a top. And so I decided to go ahead and purchase some more of this, and they had it in stock, and so I was really excited. And not only did they have it in stock, but since they've had it for so long and it was a seasonal item, I think it was about two years ago, it's on sale. And so I decided to go ahead and purchase 2 yards of this, and I'm going to go ahead and make a matching top. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and show you the things that I got from Fabric Mart that are new to me and that I've never sewn with before. So I decided to pick up this cobalt blue 100% cotton Oxford shirting. It's on a 46-inch wide fabric, and I got 3.5 yards of this because I want to make a top and possibly a dress, or not a dress, sorry, a top and possibly a skirt. And then also, if I have anything left over, I want to make my son something as well. And so this is, like I said, this right here, and it's an Oxford cotton. And I actually took some videos, so that I'm gonna go ahead and show you the videos, because you'll get a clearer picture of what's going on, and you'll be able to see the fabrics up and close. And this is a somewhat of a textured piece, but like I said, it is an Oxford cotton, but it has a slight texture on the face of the cotton. And it just feels really, really smooth, but it also has like this almost like a waffle appeal to it. So I really love this, and I'm hoping to, like I said, make a shirt and a skirt, and then possibly a top for my son. I also picked up another shirting fabric. This one is a cotton sateen, and it is a red and blue floral print. So the background is red, and the foreground you have your light and your darker blue flowers. And I think that this is just like such a gorgeous piece. It has a slight sheen on the face of it because it is a cotton sateen, and it's very lightweight. So I wouldn't say very lightweight, it's not like a voile or anything like that, and it's not it's translucent, but it's not sheer, and so you can't really see through it. And it's a really nice not stiff drape, but it has a semi stiff drape to it, and it moves so heavenly. And so I really like the, like I said, the face of it feels really smooth, and I also like the drape of it. And obviously it's cotton, and I love natural fibers. And so I think I have 4 yards. I purchased 4 yards of this, and so my intentions were to make me a mommy and me matching set with me and my son. and maybe make him like a Hawaiian type, because I think this would lend itself well as kind of like those little Hawaiian shirts that men and boys wear. So I think that that would be really cool. So I would make him kind of like a fun little playful button up top, and then maybe make me a tiered maxi dress or a maxi skirt or something like that to that effect. And if I make the skirt, my plan is, because I told you guys I'm really into making matching sets now, my plan is to not only make a skirt to go with my son's matching set, but also with this Oxford cotton. See, don't those two look beautiful together? Have this as a top and this as a skirt. I think that that would just look so great. And so I also picked up a piece from Hobby Lobby as well. Now with this particular piece, I was thinking about fall and what kind of colors I want to wear this year, or what type of dresses or skirts or things like that that I want to wear this fall. And when I went into Hobby Lobby, I saw this piece right here, and it is such a beautiful, beautiful fabric. And so anytime I'm thinking about fall, I'm thinking about those type of rustic colors, and I think this falls into that category. I really love the background. I am a huge fan of any kind of burgundy type of fabrics, and so this one right here is just, it just reminds me of like cinnamon, and I love cinnamon. I love the smell of cinnamon, especially during the holidays. And so I really love this, and I can see this as a skirt. I can see it as a top. I can see it as some type of dress that has shearing on it, or a top that has some shearing on it. It just looks so gorgeous. And as you can see, it has all these beautiful flowers on it. And you can see it has like the traditional orange type rustic color. That's like the traditional fall color. So I'm really excited about that piece and hoping to make something with it. I don't really know yet what I want to make with it, but I think it is a beautiful piece for fall. All right, so that's it for my fabric haul. Let's talk about the activewear patterns that I picked up. And yeah, I'm gonna show you what those patterns look like. All right, so I have three Simplicity patterns and one Quick Sew pattern. Quick Sew was not on sale. However, they do have the 30% off Quick Sew anytime you go into Hobby Lobby and Joann's. They usually have that standard 30% off of all the patterns. And so although you're not paying the sticker price, you still aren't paying that $1.99 or that $2.99 that we all love so much. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the Simplicity 8560, and that is this pattern right here. And this pattern, let me see if I can get it to have less light. There we go. Okay, so this pattern here is a pattern that has three different variations of a sports bra, and you have the band that different band sizes that are included with the sports bra as well. So I'm going to show you the line art here in a moment, but I want to tell you the suggested fabrics just in case you're interested. So it says that patterns were designed to be made with fabric that has approximately 50 to 60% stretch from selvage to selvage. And then the suggested fabrics are activewear knits, jersey, spandex, spandex blends, stretch lace, and any type of two-way stretch knit. And for view B, which is one of the views that they have on the envelope that has an inset, it says that you can use a stretch mesh for that inset. And then you also need one and an eighth inch bra back closure and with a hook and eye. So, and then the bra sizes are A, B, and C, and they go from 30A to 44G. And this is what the back of the garment looks like. As you can see here, you have like almost like a triangle type open back for A, a round open back for view B, and for view C, you have these little crisscross pieces that you're going to be putting in the back of the bra. And then to go with that, I purchased the Simplicity 8212, which is activewear pants. And you have four different variations here. You have View A, which is just the front and the back, and you don't have any other details for that. View C, you have a side. You have side pieces where you can do like color blocking, and it's the same for View C as well. And then which view is that that has the wider band? View D has a wide band as well. So you have different options of color blocking and different bandwidths and things like that. And so that's why I picked that one up. I think it'll be really cute as a set. With this here, I think these two would be really cool as a set, so that's why I picked those two up. And then I picked up the Quicksew K4163. This is a pattern that goes from extra small to extra large, and that's this pattern right here. So it's another active wear combo. So you have your pants, your shorts, and then you also have a top that you can make as well. Now the back is really interesting. It has this back that has like this almost like a racer back, but you also have like a piece that you're going to be sewing on the bottom as well. So it's very interesting. You also can do color blocking on these pieces as well, because it has a front and a side front. So you also can do color blocking on those options as well. So it's a pretty cool pattern that I think would lend itself well to active wear. So that's why I picked that up. And then this last pattern is not an active wear pattern. It's like a swimwear. It's made by Gertie, and it's not a new pattern. This is an older pattern, been out for some time. And I was thinking about taking this halter top piece and transforming it into some type of a swim set, or like a swimwear for the top piece of it. Now this does call for boning, and so I would probably omit the boning and also select a fabric that is more swimwear friendly. This particular pattern for that view, that's view B, it's actually calling for fabrics like just stretch woven. So it's calling for fabrics such as stretch wovens, but it's not saying specifically what type of stretch wovens. I would actually use some type of a scuba knit or something like that. Obviously, I would need to tweak the pattern and refit the pattern so that it can be designed for swimwear and for scuba knits. I just wanted the base of the pattern, basically, so that I didn't have to start from scratch and build something all the way up. I just wanted to have something that I can start with a base and then kind of build the pattern up from there. So that's why I purchased that pattern, because I want to make a swim top out of that. So that is all that I have today. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I am so excited about everything, and I hope that you enjoyed this video. All right, friends, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for tuning in today. If you enjoyed yourself and you enjoyed this video, please make sure that you give me a big thumbs up. And if you haven't done so already, please make sure that you subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you can receive notifications of all my videos when I post them. All right, friends, thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope you all have a joyous and happy sewing week. Stay creative, everyone. Bye.